Hello and welcome to the second day of the UKYP annual sitting 2012. Now this is our second day of our 3-day big residential, where all the MIPs from across the whole country are gathering together for one big residential, where we'll be going to various workshops. And so far, Julie and I have been to quite a few workshops, and all the others have as well. One which we're going to go to though later on is about impartiality, to make sure that we're not being biased towards one particular political party.
Not all of us!
And also, I'll be getting the chance to interview some very special guests, so even more on top of yesterday's very special guest, Tim Walton. I'll be getting to hopefully interview some of the younger branches of the four main political parties. So we're going to have the Conservative Future, we're going to have Young Labour, and we're going to have Young Lib Dems, and perhaps even the Green Party. We'll see how it goes, but you'll get the chance to hear their views on some of these main issues. And we'll also be interviewing one or two other MYPs as well, so hopefully you'll get to see a few more of these interviews, okay?
My name's Andrew Scrag, I'm a youth worker from Wolverhampton. My role is to support the work of the City's Youth Council of Wolverhampton, and also to support the work of the City's Youth MPs and deputies, amongst other things that I do for the youth service.
Okay, could I just ask you something about the UKYP and the City?
Yes, fine, yeah, go ahead.
Yep. So why do you believe it's so beneficially important for everyone who's attending?
Well, in terms of the experience really, obviously it provides opportunity for young people to network, not just with other young people from their own area, some instances, the region, but with young people from across the country. It gives young people a platform to raise shared concerns around topics of interest towards young people. Also, more importantly, it just gives the youth MPs a chance to have really fun as well in the role. That's quite hard work and can be quite challenging throughout their time in office.
So Ben, please can you tell us about your organisation?
Sure, we've been going since 2006 and we provide online text and paper voting services for people like UK Youth Parliament, British Youth Council. We also do a lot of work with organisations like the Scouts, Cabinet and Cabinet Club, where we provide membership and engagement services, primarily with the view to get people to vote online, to reduce the cost of printing ballot papers, distributing ballot papers, and then counting.
So all in all, your services kind of makes life easier, doesn't it, when you're voting?
It makes it easier for the voter, because all they need to do is go online and literally type in the secure code, and then they vote. And it makes it much easier for the organisation electing, because they can literally go to an administration system, they can see how many votes have been cast in real time, and at the end of the election, they don't have to do any counting of paper ballots, it's all automatically done through the administration side.
Okay, thank you, Ben.
Thank you. All right.
Hi, my name is Jabeen Risby and I am the MYP for the London Borough of Camden.
Okay, so why do you believe that impartiality is so important as an MYP, particularly on things like the annual sitting like we're this weekend?
I think impartiality is really important because, first, you've been elected to represent young people and you can only represent them fully to your fullest potential when you listen to different viewpoints, when you are open-minded, when you understand different viewpoints and you are empathising with them. Only then can you even form a relationship in which there's trust, understanding and confidence within young people.
Hi, Aruf. What's your biggest highlight of the day so far?
The media workshop, because it was funny and we learned lots of skills on how to deliver a successful interview.
Okay, and Nathan, there you are. What's your biggest highlight?
My biggest highlight of the day has been the first workshop, Advanced Democracy. It was very useful and I gained a lot from it.
Okay, thanks Nathan. See you later on.
Thank you.